Love. up this praise, Father. We're grateful for you, Holy Spirit.
Come, glory to your name.
Be in our midst today. Though we be few in number, may we be mighty in spirit today.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
You are worthy to be praised.
Anybody else have any special prayer requests today?
Brother Busby, son of Jake, said he put a little down in the back.
Yes.
My granddaughter's husband, Emmy Yeager.
Yes.
Kind of COVID.
Yes.
And then, I had a friend who passed away yesterday. I worked with her in the pottery where I worked. Cecilia Merton, Peters, I'm not sure that I can name now, but anyhow, she was a good person, she was a godly person. I remember the name.
Amen. Remember that. Anybody else?
I talked to Tay this morning, and they put her mom in Clinton Nursing Home. She's in Lucas right now. Hale's gonna come to church, but they got to get all that done today, so remember them. And my sister Teresa is in a nursing home at Mills, and she told me, we've got a situation that's gonna take God to perform a miracle.
I went to church to pray about the situation. My brother-in-law, Craig, a good guy, really good guy, but he's over her estate. And he's having, he didn't realize how much financial fight went on here in Akron, putting them in nursing home. And so Tuesday, they gotta make a decision. Would you pray with us about Freddie Marshall? Yeah, remember that.
Let's keep Richard's sister paying for it.
Chloe.
Our neighbor, his daughter died, so keep her with him.
Remember our nation. Folks, if God don't intervene, I don't know if we're gonna survive this.
That's right, brother.
We need to move to God.
It's an earnest desire.
Amen. Brother Richard, will you lead us in prayer today?
Glory to your name.
Heavenly Father, we just come before you right now humbly. Yes, sir, your name, thank you, and we give you praise. And Lord, all these requests that have just been answered, we pray that you would intervene and roll back your sisters and Hale, and that you would come through, Lord, so powerful and glory.
Thank you, touch me, Lord.
Lord, as you do miracles, as you give wisdom and insight, Father, that you just place your hand in all of us and protect us and guard us and keep us safe and healthy. And Lord, we just thank you for your anointing and thank you for the blessings. And we ask that you continue to move in our midst. In Jesus' name.
Thank you.
Wednesday, if the Lord tarries, we're going to have a Cajun seafood boil at my house today. We're going to have some shrimp and crab. Have a big time over there, but half my family ain't going to be able to make it because they're quarantined there. This is going to sing this for me today.
You got to take that, don't you?
Yeah.
Oh,
Amen, amen.
What's the name of the woman?
Praise the Lord.
Good name.
It is good to be in the house this morning.
Yes.
Thank God, today is the day of salvation.
Yes.
There's still hope. Amen.
Yes.
If we have breath in our body, there is still hope. And the Bible still says, if God be for you, who can be against you? Who can effectively be against you? When we have the Lord, when we make Him part of our life, amen. He said, behold, I stand at the door and knock. He's knocking. He wants to be a part. When you knock on someone's door, you're hoping someone would come and answer and let you in. And that's exactly what He does to us, church. By the power of the Holy Spirit, He knocks on our heart's door. And when we open up to Him, oh, what a difference it makes. It changes everything. It changes everything. And He's given to us all that we need.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. He said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. And so many times we spend worried, fretting, something that hadn't even happened yet. And it's just that the enemy of your soul wants to so consume your thought life,
yes,
that he keeps you crippled. Amen. That is a trick of the enemy. And that's why he said, cast all your cares upon me. He said, be anxious for nothing, but come to me in prayer. I'm paraphrasing, but I'm telling you, it's in there. Because he knows what we deal with, and he has the answer. He said, I come to give life. I come to give life.
Amen.
And give it more abundantly.
Yes.
He said, the thief comes to steal, to kill, and destroy. And much of this today is going on in our mind. Amen.
Yes.
Years ago, I'm talking years, this is an old book now, but Sister Joyce Myers, anointed teacher of God, put out a book, Battlefield of the Mind.
Yes.
I'd say if you don't have that at home, you need to make that a part of your library.
Okay.
And I would say, look that thing over. You could read that twice a year, and I believe it'll get you back on track. I'm not standing up here separated talking about how perfect I am. I'm telling you, I battle from here and there and everywhere. And it all stems back to the fact that think about what you're thinking about.
Amen.
But we waste too much time thinking about the wrong stuff. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Because he's a thief and he steals our time. Right there.
Amen.
You ever try to think about two things at once? I know people brag, I'm a multitasker. But it's really hard to think about two things at once. The enemy knows that. Amen. Amen. Y'all with me today? I want to announce, I think it was Tuesday or Wednesday morning, I was at work and phone rung, and it was the Gideons, and they're going to be here next Sunday to make a presentation, and you know, that's a great cause. That's a great thing. So keep in mind that. And, you know, normally they collect an offering during that service at some point to a great cause. They provide the Word of God,
yeah,
to so many people that would not have that. Aren't you thankful that, you know, we just take it for granted. But there's many that can't even purchase a Bible, and they do that.
Amen.
And they advance the cause of the gospel. Good organization. But they will be here next Sunday for the preaching part of the service. The gospel. Thank God for
The gospel. I want to share this morning about the gospel. You know, it's been said the gospel is what? Good news. It's good news. You ever had bad news? I don't like bad news. You can get bad news, and it just destroys your peace. Man, I've been having a good week, and you know, I get home, and my wife says we got a letter from the IRS. That destroys your peace. That's bad news. And you know, we're talking to the tax guy, and you know, it's not all cut and dry, but he said, you know, I heard it said one time that there was a party celebration, you know, and people were there, maybe a reunion, and they were gathered around communicating, and everybody didn't know everybody, and they'd say, well, what do you do? And they'd share, and, oh yeah, you know, that sounds like an interesting job. And one fellow says, I'm an IRS agent, and everybody just dispersed.
Yeah.
Is that not true? I'm going to tell you, I'm trying not to get sidetracked. These people.